We have guests in the room. Clean this mess up.
That's impossible.
Too late.
You know, over the weekend, of course, we were celebrating International Women's Day, and we were very active online watching our friends and participating as well. And I thought we should take it a step further. As you know, God, I don't know where to start. Procter & Gamble. We'll start with Procter & Gamble. You know, Procter & Gamble and their incredible brands that are under their umbrella have been so actively working toward equality for many years. This is nothing new at Procter & Gamble. But now, along with iHeart and Seneca Women Podcast Network, we're taking it a step further, bringing more podcasts to our network under our umbrella. And so here from Procter & Gamble, Chief Brand Officer Mark Pritchard. Good morning, Mark.
Good morning, Ellis.
And Kim Azzarelli from Seneca Women Podcast Network.
Good morning.
Thank you for coming in today.
Great to be here.
Danielle Gandhi.
Hello.
Hi, Danielle.
And I'm your moderator. And also, from our decision and for all podcasts at iHeartMedia, Connell Byrne is here. Hi, Connell.
Hey, how are you guys? Thanks
for having me. All right, Connell, I'm going to start with you, even though Procter & Gamble are friends, are Blue Ribbon guests today. As far as our huge, massive podcast network goes, why do you feel this is one of the most important additions and merging situations that we've had in a long time?
So the iHeart Podcast Network is the biggest commercial podcast network in the United States. And what that means in just plain speak is we have about 200 million downloads a month across hundreds of podcasts. What we're trying to do better in podcasting and get right out of the gate is more female voices, better representation. It's a new medium. We have a chance to set the rules of the road right out of the gate. And so we were looking for a really good partner to launch into that with and make sure we do it right. And Seneca Women, led by Kim, is trying to do that. They want to launch 5, 10, 15 podcasts across the next few years to represent women's voices, women's stories, backed by Mark and Procter & Gamble. So it made a ton of sense for us to jump in and try to support that.
I love that ever since we started this conversation, it's all been guys.
Yep.
Yeah. Right. I know.
So true. I'm gonna end that right now. Well, let's go to you, Kim.
Yes.
Seneca Women Podcast Network.
Yes.
Before teaming up with Procter & Gamble mm-hmm. and iHeart, mm-hmm. what else are you guys up to?
Well, Seneca
there?
Women's all about kind of amplifying the voices of women around the world. So we've been doing this for years, frankly. A lot of live events. We wrote a book called Fast Forward, How Women Can Achieve Power and Purpose. But we've really been about trying to get the stories of women out there. And we started getting into audio a couple years back. We have an app called the Seneca Women app, and it has all different types of content around women that we feel has been maybe underrepresented. And so when we got into audio, we started a show called Conversations on Power and Purpose. And the purpose of the show was really to tell the stories of incredible women who you may know, like Tori Burch and Katie Couric, but also when you don't know, that you haven't heard of. And so we did that. And then we realized, wow, when we did the research, we saw that only 20% of podcast hosts are women. And we thought, no, this medium cannot go the same way that every media has gone for the past 150 years. So we still have a lot of catch-up work to do in media generally, with only 10% of film directors being women. With we know that only 20%, frankly, of GMs of radio stations are women. But the podcasting, which has kind of just come on the scene the last 10, 15 years, we can't let this go the same direction. So we thought, no, this is a great medium for women. It's a great way to share women's voices. And so we thought, let's promote and basically produce as many great women as we can in this next couple of years.
What are some of the shows that you already have on there? Like some of the podcasts we can get right now?
Well, right now, today, we're featuring Katie Couric this morning. We're featuring Arianne Huffington. We're featuring Tori Burch. Last week, we did something great on Justice Sandra Day O'Connor. We have the woman who's the head of UN Women, who's really amazing. We have the first president of Ireland, who was a woman, Mary Robinson. I mean, it's a real range of women's voices. We also have men's voices because we think it's really important to showcase men and women who are using their power for purpose. That's the first major theme of our podcast. And so you'll see men on there who are making a huge difference. So it's really not just about a women's issue. We think that women's issues are everyone's issues. It's about getting positive content out there and making sure that women's voices are heard.
So when an opportunity arises to merge with a powerhouse like Procter & Gamble, knowing what their messaging has been mm-hmm. for several years now, that must be amazing. Is it okay if you and Mark discuss about how you guys decided this just makes all the sense in the world?
Well, it was a no-brainer. We've been working with Kim and Seneca Women for some time now, and P&G has been working on really using our voice in advertising and media as a force for good by, first, the accurate portrayal and authentic portrayal of women and girls in all advertising and media, and second, taking stands, like things like always like a girl, that literally changed the meaning of the word of the phrase like a girl. 19% of people thought it was a positive expression before we did like a girl. 76% of people now think it's a positive expression. That's the power that advertising can have. So we've been working with Kim. Kim said, hey, I got this idea for a podcast network. And literally with Allison Tooman, who's also here, within about 3 seconds, we said, we're in. It was such a perfect combination of us bringing together. Kim has amazing connections with so many people throughout government, NGOs, corporations, and other places. And then we have then connections to the media and advertising world and with our brands. So bringing our stories together was the perfect connection.
So you guys have to be getting bombarded with people wanting to be part of this, right?
Yeah.
How are you picking through all the content to figure out what's going to go on?
I mean, we're really trying to tell stories that haven't been told before and women who might not get that opportunity. So there's a lot of women who really have great things to say, but they haven't had the chance to express and they don't have a medium. It's not that easy, actually, as you know,
right,
to get on air. And so we're looking for stories that haven't been told before, history that hasn't been told before, practical. Our whole network is about practical, positive, purpose-driven work. So we want things that are actionable, ways that we can kind of learn from each other. And so we're looking for women who are interested in that.
So if someone has a great idea, how would they get in contact with you guys?
Kim@SenecaWomen.com.
Now you asked for it.
Here comes that inbox, Kim. It's all over now.
I think we can all, I think each and every one of us can come up with the answer to this question. Mm-hmm. But why is it still a challenge? I mean, what year is this?
That's a very interesting point that you're bringing up. What year is this? So this is the year of 2020. This is the 100th anniversary of suffrage in this country, which is, as you know, the right to vote for women. So women gained the right to vote only 100 years ago, which maybe seems like a long time, but there's so many things that women have not had access to even in recent years. And so the fact that we were talking, Mark and I were talking earlier, for example, in media in particular, Gina Davis, who has this incredible institute around women in media, tells us that in crowd scenes in movies, there are only 17% of women. So 50% of the population, but in the crowd scenes, only 17% of crowds are women. So we might be conditioned to think that 17% is representation. So everywhere you go around the world, you see that we're stuck. We're stuck somewhere between 17 and now it's etching up, I would say, to 20-25% in leadership. It doesn't matter where you look, if it's business, if it's government, wherever you look, it's about 20-25%. So it is an epidemic, I would say. But I think with people like Mark and P&G, what is so incredible about this partnership and now with iHeart is that we have the chance to influence culture and the way people think about these issues. I mean, like a girl literally changed the meaning of like a girl from being negative to being positive. So
yeah, because growing up, it was don't throw like a girl.
Yeah, you throw like a girl.
Right.
You know, and now it's
thankfully it's not like that anymore.
And you know, in advertising and media and radio and all media have an impact on popular culture. They have an impact on how people see themselves and how they see the world, which is why we have to peel back and shine the light on the situation we have. And in order to have accuracy and authenticity and equality in front of the camera or in front of the microphone, you've got to have it behind there. You've got to get, so that's why what we have to do is invest in, identify who are these women-owned businesses that we can spend money with. It's astounding that after all this time, only 10.6% of films are directed by women. It's astounding that the podcast network only has 20% of women who are behind the microphone. We should change that. And that's one of the reasons why partnerships between companies like P&G and Seneca Women Podcast are so important.
I have to just add to that one piece of this. I mean, the idea that an advertising entity at this size and magnitude wants to actually make making women's narratives a priority is a very big deal. I mean, that is a newsworthy thing. This has not been the case, as we know, for a very long time. Advertising has not put women's perspectives as the front and center. And I think what we've seen in the last several years, and I have to say has a lot to do with Mark Pritchard sitting here, you know, this intentional use of advertising dollars to shift the narrative around women and girls is, I think, something that's frankly revolutionary in the most positive way. And I think, again, it's this accurate portrayal. We're not trying to tip the balance in any weird way. We're just saying this is what the world is. This is what the world looks like. Women have a perspective. Sometimes it's better. Sometimes it's worse. But we need to have everybody at the table, at the mic, frankly.
So a question for you, Mark, as far as Procter & Gamble, as far as P&G goes, is there a way, and this is the shallow question, I just want to ask it because it is going somewhere, is there a way to actually make a connection between P&G's stance and actual profits? Do you see the company thriving because of this?
Absolutely. In fact, business can and should be the greatest force for good in the future. But what it also has to do is connect it to growth. Because if it's a force for good only, it's a philanthropy. And that's nice, but it's not enough. If it's a force for good and a force for growth, it's a sustainable business model. So what we've chosen to do is build in equality and build in diversity and inclusion into all of the work that we do. So it starts with what I just described, the accurate portrayal of all humanity. Accuracy just helps people see themselves. And we've actually got evidence from the hashtag SeeHer movement that has studied over 100,000 ads that indicates that if you have an accurate portrayal of women and girls in advertising, it has a 10% increase in trust ratings, which kind of stands the test of reason. Because
right.
If you see somebody,
very much
you
so.
See yourself, you trust them better. Mm-hmm. And then it has an impact on sales as well. Our business is Always, which is done like a girl, and End Period Poverty right now. Olay, which has done Make Space for Women to Face Anything. SK2, Change Destiny. All of these, Secret, All Strength, No Sweat, All About Equality. All of these brands who take, not only do the accurate and authentic portion, they also take stands. They're all growing. So there is a absolute correlation. In fact, I would say one leads to the other when you do it well.
And there's Charmin, Enjoy the Go, which
Enjoy
is a whole different.
Yeah, yeah. We all
ready?
Go.
Everyone so. Now. My honey's clean.
Yeah,
yeah,
Charmin.
Yeah.
Charmin. And I can't find
exactly
Charmin.
Good. I knew you were going there.
But not for Charmin. Back, back to your point.
But I mean, about Secret, I just want to take Secret as an example. So last year for pay equality, Secret took this incredible stand on girls' soccer, right? We know that. Yeah. And Secret actually topped it off so that they could make equal pay into the men's soccer league. That to me is unbelievable. You can't imagine 10 years ago brands taking such a stand for women the way they are today. So I think, you know, we're under, I think, stating the leadership role that P&G has, because you see a lot of other companies are trying to do the same thing. And that's really exciting.
Well, this is what's so exciting. It doesn't matter the size of your business, small, medium, or behemoth like P&G. I mean, you hear how P&G is actually seeing results from doing the right thing.
Exactly.
So that should be able to be applied to any and every business. 100%. I think that's really cool.
Any business and every business can do it. And when, you know, there's actually several businesses that are out there making the same kinds of work. But what we're hoping to do is have Seneca Women Podcast Network really shine the light on all the brilliant work that's going on, so more and more do it. Because imagine if everybody did this. Mm. Imagine the impact if every single company had the accurate portrayal, shined the light on equality. We would have a big sea change in terms of how women equality and inclusion are happening.
I always give the same example because it always comes to my mind in every conversation, but Justice O'Connor, who was the first woman on the Supreme Court, as you know, when there was that whole period of the Arab Spring many years ago where women were basically encouraging this revolution, really. And she had said, if women weren't there to draft the Constitution, you'd lose another 100 years. So women in decision-making powers at that moment. I always think of that when I think of this moment in media. If women are not behind the mic, as we see here they are, mm-hmm. You know, we have this chance to make this medium go the same direction as every other medium. And that's years and years of progress lost. So this moment with iHeart, with P&G and Mark, I think this is a really important moment for women. And in the year of 2020, which is this historical year, we feel that we have the chance to kind of course correct what's been happening. And this new medium of podcasting is so powerful. And radio is so exciting that it's so great to see to see you guys here behind the mic. So I really appreciate what you're doing, Elvis.
It really is cool, I have to say. That and it's such an important point. If every company and every partnership that you had, if you thought about and looked around the room and said, do we have equality here? Do we truly have gender and intersectional equality in this room? If we did, then business and everything would be a lot better. That's why we love the iHeart partnership, why Seneca Women is such a great partnership. Mm-hmm. Companies, when you think about that intentionally, we can make the difference. Back to the point is, why are we in 2020 and we're still not there? We have to make it intentional to make a difference.
Well, they kick my ass every day.
Keep going.
We're working on it.
Thank God. Anyway, as far as our podcasts go, Connell, of course, from iHeartMedia and our podcast department. I mean, what do you have on the horizon that you can talk about?
I think, first of all, about 2 or 3 weeks ago, we made a pledge that of all the new production that we create, period, in the next year, half of it will be from women, for women, by women. What really candidly impressed us with Kim and Seneca Women with Mark's backing was just how driven and intentional the plan was. It wasn't so much, we should make some podcasts by women and for women. It was
quick.
It was a multi-year plan. It was right. Like we have five or six shows that we've developed and want to green light and go on. We want to make five or six more in year one. It was a pretty robust, very intentional driven plan. And that's how we work at iHeart. So that resonated with us and we wanted to jump in. You know, listen, selfishly, I like podcasts. I'm a podcast super fan. This all just makes for better content too. Mm. You don't want to have half of your creative base absent if you can help it. And so I think that's selfishly what I want to do just for listeners and audiences. But I just keep going back to this point of if you have a chance, it's not that often that a new medium actually comes along and takes hold. You think about it, more mediums come and go than actually stick around and become a permanent new way that people listen to content. And it looks like podcasting is going to do that, be a true new permanent mass reach medium. We have about another few years here to set those rules right. And so I think I can't think of better partners to do that with than Mark or Kim to say, look, let's make it so we don't have to come back 100 years from now and say, oh, yeah, let's invite in the other half of the creative pool. I think we can do that right now.
Hey, Kim, now that Procter & Gamble has stepped up to the plate, mm-hmm. well, and they have been for several years, but now with you personally mm-hmm. and with Seneca Women Podcast Network, do you see other corporations starting to go, okay.
I do. I mean, there are so many. I've been working at this for a very long time. I'm a former Avon person. I used to be at Avon. And so I always believed in the power of a company that could put women at the center of its strategy. What's different now is that companies that did not focus on women traditionally or didn't see themselves as traditionally women's companies, all industries understand the power of the women consumer now. So I amazing story from Anne Moore, who used to be the CEO of Time Inc. When she wanted to make people more oriented towards women, she went to the advertisers and the publisher, and they're like, oh, no. If you make people a women's magazine, we're going to lose all the advertising. They're like, we'll lose all of auto. You know, and she's like, who do you think is making decisions on cars?
Women don't drive cars.
Yeah. She's like, what are you thinking, people? And so she had to literally put, this was many years ago, she had to put video cameras in the car parking lots to show when the people were driving off the dealer lot who was making the decision.
Wait, she had to do that?
Yes, she had to do that.
That's kind of funny.
Now, let's just say, fast forward, she became the CEO of Time Inc. And the other guy, I don't know what happened to him. But point is, like, she saw something. But it's that, you know, that wasn't so long ago. But even today, 10 years ago, same issue. 5 years ago, same issue. But today you see now financial services companies, auto. I mean, Toyota doing great things for women. Bank of America, amazing. We just started a Center for Women's Entrepreneurship at Cornell. Amazing stuff going on for women because of these different big companies who recognize that women have power. And as Mark was saying, you can do well and do good. And so doing the right thing turns out to be doing the profitable thing. Oh, my God, who would have thought? So that's very exciting for everybody. And so we're seeing more and more companies following in Mark Pritchard's shoes. I mean, basically, people do follow what Mark does in this sort of CMO world. So I think the fact that P&G has stepped up to do this, we will see, I think, a sea change in the way companies think about their advertising.
This is all great news. So Mark Pritchard, mm-hmm. Chief Brand Officer for Procter & Gamble, Kim Azzarelli, of course, CEO of Seneca Women Podcast Network, and O'Connell Byrne, our own. From iHeart Podcast, thank you very much for coming in today. That was awesome.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you. Good.